Christmas, in loving memory of Janice Thedore, and for the birth of Walker Kenneth, who celebrates today his 9th birthday. Together with our different intentions, we now begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask blessed Mary, the Virgin, all angels and saints, through my brothers and sisters, pray for me, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith, we may possess in unending love. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest rose up, and all his companions, that is, the party of the Sadducees, and filled with jealousy, laid hands upon the apostles and put them in the public jail. But during the night, the angel of the Lord opened the doors of the prison, let them out, and said, "Go and take your place in the temple area and tell the people everything about this life." When they heard this, they went to the temple early in the morning and taught. When the high priest and his companions arrived, they convened the Sanhedrin, the full senate of the children of Israel, and sent to the jail to have them brought in. But the court officers who went did not find them in the prison, so they came back and reported, "We found the jail securely locked and the guards stationed outside the doors. But when we opened them, we found no one inside." When the captain of the temple guard and the chief priests heard this report, they were at a loss about them as to what this would come to. Then someone came in and reported to them, "The men whom you put in prison are in the temple area and are teaching the people." Then the captain and the court officers went and brought them, but without force, because they were afraid of being stoned by the people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extolled his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
The Lord is the rock of the poor.
Look to him, that you may be readily with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved them. The Lord is the cry of the poor. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him.
The Lord is the cry of the poor.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come towards the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works might be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
We are still journeying with the apostles. With the reactions they got because of the Easter event, the power of God at hand. In today's first reading, the bars of the prison cannot contain the power of God. The apostles were in prison and yet set free at night. And to the surprise of the religious leaders who presumed them to be still in jail, under the directive of the angel, learned of them being in the temple area preaching to the people. However, this time, they were handled with care for fear that since now the apostles had a large following, those court officials, the captain, would easily be stoned if they mishandled them. In the Gospel, we still continue reflecting on the dialogue between Nicodemus and Jesus. And today Jesus reveals to Nicodemus God's love for the world, identifying the beneficiaries to this very love. Those who do not only believe in the only begotten Son of God, but also translate the belief in their concrete lives. Jesus also makes clear his mission to Nicodemus, that he came to save the world, that is to save man through man's own free will. Salvation is not imposed to us. God has done his part, but at the same time, our contribution is very vital for us to benefit in the salvation that was gained by the sacrifice of the only begotten Son of God. Free will seen in either embracing the light or darkness through our everyday choices that we make in life. In today's first reading, we are therefore encouraged always to try our best in all that we do, regardless of the challenges that we may encounter in what we do, aware that no one can suffocate the good done with a right intention. The apostles had a right intention. They were doing what they were supposed to do. And to the surprise of all those prison officials, still they prevailed in all that they did. Yes, you may suffer for what you do, but always there will be an angel to intervene and redeem the situation. It could be in your own marriage. It could be in your own profession. It could be in the charity that you do, that after offering charity, you meet a lot of confrontations, or even in your own faith witness. All we need is to persevere until God's hand comes and takes an upper hand. The gospel is a reminder to us that we shall be the cause of our own condemnation by the choices that we make every day, either the choices that portray us as children of light, or those choices that portray us as children of darkness. The challenge is, do I do what I do with the knowledge that everything I do will contribute either to my justification or my condemnation at the end of time? God has done his part and is upon me to do my own so as to benefit in the salvation that is won for us. For Pope Francis and all bishops, may the Holy Spirit be their strength as they shepherd the faith closer to his heart, with prayer to the Lord. For national and local leaders, may the Lord be their guide in their efforts to promote the sanctity of life, we pray to the Lord. For those experiencing grief or loss, may the consolation of the Holy Spirit be upon them, we pray to the Lord. for each one of us gathered here, may the grace of Easter season help us to be faithful to live out our own baptismal mission of being priest, prophet, and a king. We pray to the Lord. And for those who have died, members of our parish community, members of our own individual families, especially those we are praying for during this Easter season, may they see God face to face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. We now take a moment to offer those prayers that lie in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayers. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heaven powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as
fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may be part of us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given out for you." In a similar way, when supper's end was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer Lord the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of their resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Our master and soul, we pray that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be compared to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, and with him, and in him. O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord's command and glory by divine teaching. Hear us,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace us and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the greatness of
God. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace us in grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always. And now let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the Son of the Lamb. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly present your people, we pray, O Lord. And lead those who have been imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia. And enjoy the rest of your day. Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle. He has set our hands in the enemies and threats of the devil. May God reward you with all your prayer. And you are the priest of the angels. For by the power of God, cast into the hell, Satan, and burn all the enemies with it, who are out of the world.
Satan.